Good morning and welcome to Coffee with Corey. I'm the host, Corey Cohen, Vice President of Marketing at TBI. TBI is a technology services distributor, and every week I introduce you to one of our technology suppliers. Before I do, it is coffee, so we chat about coffee with every guest, but I always talk about what's happening in my life. Honestly, not much this week. So instead, I'm super curious to learn what people's favorite purchases have been during COVID. I can without a doubt say that I'm pretty certain for me, the air fryer was one of the best purchases I've made and highly recommend. Also, I bought these like fancy blue light glasses, which I don't know if it's a placebo effect. I feel like it works. I feel like I'm getting less eye strain during the day, so that's cool. Perhaps I will set up a Amazon best of, like things that I've purchased. Yeah, my favorite things. Maybe kind of similar to what I did with the Spotify playlist, which I don't know if anyone listened to, but it was like coffee house jams. If anyone listens to XM radio, I put together a Spotify playlist. It's still there. We can post the link, but I might do that on Amazon. However, I will say most of my purchases, most of my favorite purchases have to do around Old Navy activewear. I'm like a real big fan of their like super soft leggings for all you women out there. Big fan. They come in a ton of colors and I find them to be super comfortable. Also coming up. Yeah. Jim. Yeah. Purchasing your TSA pre-check. Like, where are you going? So Thanksgiving is coming up. We don't have a show next Wednesday. We are doing absolutely nothing for Thanksgiving. We're not even seeing my parents. Oh, I love that you said that, Sherry, that you bought the best sheets and duvet, because I actually, oh my God, poor George, my guest, because I have something to share about that. Sherry. My husband and I are not the tallest people. I'm 5'2". He's taller than that. I think 5'8". You would think that like two small people wouldn't be annoying with like pulling sheets and making sure we both have enough. Yet it is a significant argument almost every night until I rectified it. Most people don't know this, and they're hard to find, but you can find Super King comforters, Super King size comforters, not California King, Super King size. I can go more into this. I've spent way too much time trying to identify comforters for small people like me. But yeah, I highly recommend Super King size comforters. There's also another size. I forgot what it's called. Palatial King. I don't know. I'll let you know. Okay. Like I said, not having a show next week for Thanksgiving. We're doing absolutely nothing. Had to break it to my, brother and his family that we're not going to join them. It's just too much of a scary time. Like, why push it? I want the kids to be able to still remain in school. I'm hoping that happens. John Oliver signed off until February and did like the most hilarious blowing up 2020 and basically saying F this. It was great. It's on YouTube if you can check it out. Okay, moving on. Today with me, Coffee with Corey. Today with me, I have George Longyear, who is Vice President of Channel Sales at Net2Phone. George.
Good morning.
Thank you so much for joining me today. How are you?
Thanks for having me.
So you are a coffee fanatic. You have multiple cups a day.
I would say probably about a pot a day. I don't know if I want to admit that, but it's probably about a whole pot a day.
So you're like my perfect guest to have on coffee, because what are you drinking with me today?
So this is my Net2Phone cup. Marketing, by the way, I need some new stuff. But I'm also I'm a big Caribou coffee fan. And I got to tell you that I usually fall for the ads, whether it's on Facebook or whatever, that, you know, they're good. I mean, they're the ads for, Black Rifle Coffee, anything that supports, you know, the military and veterans and whatnot. I typically have a few bags of those in my cabinet as well.
I love that. Okay, so tell me, where do you live?
I live in the Charlotte, North Carolina area.
Awesome. And B, you have quite a larger family. How many kids do you have?
So that's funny. Funny you should ask. So I have three daughters in various stages of life. One graduated from college already, and two are in college. And I have a 18-month-old son as well. So you could say, you know, hit the reset button there, but four kids.
Yeah, you sure did hit the reset button. That's fun times over there.
Oh, yeah. You got to love it.
You're back to a lot of poop discussions, just like.
Yeah, I mean, as of just as this morning. So if you need to know.
I could have opened this segment talking a lot about poop. I spared people. However, I did. What the hell was I thinking when I got some cream-colored chairs in my bedroom in a sitting area? Because I will tell you that my 2-year-old, he pooped on it. He pooped on that chair. And I'm like, no!
Amazon has stuff for that. Amazon has stuff to get that out.
100% they do. I bought it. Yeah, it's called Spot Shot, guys. Spot Shot. And I will put it under my favorite things. Get it on Amazon. So, okay, so talk to me. I mean, like, that's crazy. A, you have an 18-month-old and you have older girls, which, by the way, three girls. Lucky you.
So the good thing, the good thing is that, you know, my daughters are, they're older now, getting old. They kind of do their own thing. So, you know, hanging out with dad is not like, you know, it's not really high on their priority list. But, you know, we get by and, you know, they've been troopers through all of this. My oldest daughter got out just before, you know, kind of graduated before this this pandemic hit. So she made it out. But my other two are, you know, they're fighting through it. Partial, virtual and partial, you know, in class. So, but you know, I think we're turning the corner here.
Yeah, I hope so. Chicago's not, I will say that. But I do hope that, you know, vaccines are in sight, which is really promising. And, it's been a struggle for everyone. So, you know, that's like understatement of 2020 as well. But it seems like you guys are doing good and that's nice. And it's really nice, you know, to have, it's actually really nice to have older kids. You know, I actually don't know what's better, but older kids seem to understand what's happening more than the my kids who are like, there's a virus. Can we go to the Kohl's Children's Museum? And I'm like, no, there's a virus. It's like, okay, you think they get it, but they don't. Anyway, moving on. George, can you talk to us about Net2Phone? Who is Net2Phone?
So Net2Phone, we are the UCAS, Unified Communications, UCAS, and SIP trunking arm for IDT International. IDT is a global provider, one of the largest global providers of voice traffic. We operate on five continents, data centers all over the globe. We leverage that network on the Net2Phone side for delivering a true in-country experience globally. We have folks that I run North America, the channel in North America, but I have peers in South America and Europe, APAC. So we actually have channel managers and feet on the street, in all over, you know, in Europe and South America, et cetera. So we're a true global provider for unified communications and SIP trunking.
I liked when you combined those words to be Trouble, a true global. I liked Trouble.
Yeah, true. Yeah, I mean it works, and it is. There's a big difference. There's a big difference on, you know, we can deliver service across the globe. When I mentioned we keep our traffic in country. We're able to either port or provide DIDs in 70 plus countries, and there's not a whole lot of providers out there that can truly say that.
It's true. We obviously jokingly say in COVID that maybe the CCAS providers conspired for COVID, because you guys are obviously having a tremendous year, because there's no other way to communicate other than through cloud communications, right, at this point, with virtual work. Sorry, like frog in my throat. But can you talk to me about your business and how it is growing during a pandemic, and what you're seeing, like what's being requested?
So it's an unfortunate situation, but we really have been growing exponentially, since the beginning of the year, even just prior, faster than ever, even prior to the pandemic, to COVID-19 hitting. But, ever since that, it's just been beat your best month, every single month up till now. And at the end of the day, I think some of it was probably foresight, and a lot of it was probably luck. We're obviously a UCaaS provider. We enable virtualization. We enable businesses to work in a distributed type of environment. But more than that, I think that some of the things that we had rolled out or were rolling out even just prior to COVID-19 hitting were native Teams, Microsoft Teams integration. That's a huge deal now. That's blown up. So and we were right at the cusp of that. We had rolled out that product, and we were seeing tremendous growth, with our Teams integration product in general. At the end of the day, when you're setting up businesses to work, in a virtual environment anyway. You're going to see the growth, and the pandemic just really just accelerated that. We're around the corner. I see the growth that's going to, it's going to continue. We can see, I think the business landscape has definitely changed, some aspects probably for the better.
Sure. So when having conversations, we're almost at Thanksgiving, which how the hell did that happen? No one knows. As we're planning for next year, what are these conversations that you're having?
So I think the conversations with businesses at this point, it's how do they see themselves, on the other side of this pandemic. And I think what we're hearing is that, companies have always had a cloud strategy. And a lot of it, revolved around virtualization in general. A lot of companies really hesitated pre-pandemic, with really rolling out remote workers, those type of things. But, with COVID-19, that Band-Aid was ripped off, and they had no other way to go. But what we're finding now is that, with that Band-Aid ripped off, customers and businesses in general are seeing that that they can be more productive. There's a lot of cost savings in virtualization, and they're seeing the productivity from their employees, which they probably were worried about prior. They're seeing that go up, and companies like Net2Phone and our competitors. It feels good. We're in that business for enabling that anyway. And without companies like us, just think about it. That this environment would not exist. It just wouldn't exist.
Sure.
So it's a good good spot to be.
So could you share with us some recent deployments or some cool case studies that kind of exemplify where Net2Phone does well?
Well, I think that I'd mentioned we're a global provider, so. We're pushing what we call our Unite product, which is a global product that, you know, that spans, is very simple to deploy, and it spans across the globe, not just in the US. People can understand it, whether it doesn't matter what country you're in. So we will do deployments that that range, you know, from New York City, and we just did one, New York City, Chicago, and then operations in Germany and in Australia. And we're able to do this. There's a lot of people working hard behind the scenes to make this look easy, and it's not. There's different rules, you know, everywhere. South America, North America, you know, Europe. It's all different. And we have some really talented folks that enable that to, you know, a smooth transition, you know, whether it be porting and porting a number in Australia or New York City. I mean, we make it look easy, but kudos to the folks behind the scenes that make it happen.
Yeah, that is awesome. You mentioned your Unite product, but what are some other things we can expect to see from Net2Phone in the coming months and even, you know, next year?
So I mean, we are, you know, constantly, we own our own platform. We're constantly, enhancing our current platform or product in general. So you're going to see that. You're going to see just a slew of new enhancements to our existing product coming down the road. We aspire to be innovative, but we also understand we don't need to reinvent the wheel. We want to enable customers to thrive in the environment they're used to, whether that be Microsoft Teams, as I've mentioned, or Slack or Salesforce, whatever. We enable folks to be more efficient in the environment that they currently are used to. From things that you will see very on the next, the upcoming months for sure, are, you know, like I mentioned, product enhancements in general, integrations, strategic partnerships with some with other players out there that will, you know, enhance our customer experience as well and move us into the enterprise space pretty solidly.
Yeah. I kind of like what you said. I mean, UCaaS is a crowded space, right? No need to reinvent the wheel, just need a better mousetrap, right? Moving on, I never really understood mousetrap. Poor mice, you know? I don't know. Anyway, I've actually never really talked about mice. Okay. Totally switching gears. Let's go back to you for a sec, George. I'm curious to know, what are you doing? Because, like, you're used to traveling all the time. You're home, which for the first time ever, which is really nice, especially because you have an 18-month son, which is fantastic. So you're actually able to enjoy this time. Not enjoy the poop. Enjoy this time. But what are you doing in all of your free time, which is limited?
Yeah, I wouldn't say I wouldn't call it free time, but it is definitely different time. I mean, the folks that do what we do in general, we're on the road. We're in front of partners. We're at, various events across the country. And, I'm probably half the month travel guy normally. And I really haven't been anywhere for business travel since, end of February. So that is, it's been different. I can tell you that for sure. So obviously there's a lot of these type meetings, and it's definitely different. I think that it bodes well, to be in front of our partners, TBI and your subs in general. I mean, I see that coming around, I think we're almost out of the woods here, hopefully. It's been okay. I mean, it's not, it's just different. I don't know how to explain. I think it's probably just different. Looking to get back on the road, there's some silver linings for sure in that. Personally, I've got an 18-month-old boy, and you don't really notice. And I can tell you, from having three older daughters now, you traveling all the time, you don't notice how fast they grow. And I've been able to, I've been able to see pretty much every moment. So it's a big deal. And you notice a lot of things that you didn't prior. So there's some silver linings in there. you get by, but binge watching, you know, all the normal stuff. I think I've really improved my game. I've definitely upped my game on cooking and grilling and smoking meats. So, you know, I maybe some of my wife might disagree with that, but I think that I have.
That's awesome. That's really cool. As the winter months are coming, I'm perfecting my chili recipe. So,
nice.
So you mentioned binge watching. We're dying to know, what are you binge watching?
Well, it's funny. It's funny. Yeah. So I kind of went like some of the old school stuff that, you know, I never saw, you know, never watched like Mad Men or, you know, I binge watched that whole deal. Game of Thrones, of course. I did that on my own. My wife wouldn't watch that with me. But, you know, I like even some of the older stuff like Lost. I mean, just some of the, you know, I probably like one of like three people that had never seen that. So, you know, just spoiler alert, they're all dead already. I was spoiling it. I think I literally am probably the only one that didn't watch. But I watched just some of the old stuff, just some of the real classic ones that were pre-pandemic stuff and just spent a lot of time. I mean, I think I'm pretty much caught up.
So you're caught up to like 2020.
Yeah, exactly. I got your time.
Let's pray that there's not another pandemic where you're going to be traveling and missing out on all of these shows and have to, you know, take some time off to catch up to the current times. Let's pray that doesn't happen ever again. I always like to end with the silver lining. We touched upon it, right? You of all people have the most perspective on this actually with such a disparate, age gap amongst your children, but you said it best. I mean, you don't realize like how much you miss when you're on the road. I mean, even me going into an office every day, traveling, yes, but like I'm even talking like day to day, you know, 10 hours a day being somewhere else, you like miss just so much. So like, I know that your silver lining is definitely being with your only son, which is fantastic. But any other color you want to shed on that?
You know, I think I can tell you what, I've done a lot more work, you know, more work around the house and whatnot than I probably ever did. Well, you know, my wife's probably gonna, you know, she may disagree, but yeah, I mean, it's, you know, the silver lining probably just is that point, you know, from a personal standpoint, you really just never, we take it for granted that we all work a lot of time. I mean, a lot of what we do in general, we're all, I think I've worked from home for 15 years. I mean, so we really take that for granted a lot. And, you know, I think that, you know, we should be, you know, we should feel blessed in a sense that we are able to do that. And we're in an industry, you know, that enables that as well. You know, I've seen, you know, my little boy transform from a little baby to a little person. I mean, it's just crazy. But yeah. You know, there's definitely that silver lining there for sure.
Yes, 100%. Honestly, those working from home who aren't used to staying at home without traveling certainly gain a different perspective on what it's like to have that non-work life balance.
Yep. Yep. Like, well, you handle it. I mean, look, it's, you know, a lot of people are understanding that that's, you know, I think that this is a new environment. It's going to be a lot of people will not go back into the office, which, you know, I think is a good thing in general in some senses too.
But I 100% agree with you. There are people who are never returning to an office again. I'm saying actually that I think some of my male, I have like so many thoughts about this subject, like, you know, behaviorally and like the psychology of the after effects of this pandemic will be studied for years, right? The pandemic, of course, will be studied, but the after effects from a psychology standpoint will be. And honestly, I think that either like male counterparts or just other people who don't have kids yet just And those that have kids and see their single employees or those that don't have kids, you just have greater empathy for each other with what they're dealing with and struggling with on a day-to-day basis that you weren't privy to before. And so honestly, one of the silver linings I hope that comes from this pandemic is just being more attuned to your fellow employees and fellow coworkers and knowing like how to navigate work, knowing that people have personalized. We always know people have personalized, only now it's like in your face how personal.
Oh yeah, I mean, it's definitely different, and I have a newfound respect for the folks that, you know, in the middle of this pandemic, I mean, the people that are front line. I mean, look at, you know, there's the folks that are, you know, in the medical field, you know, they don't have that luxury. So it's definitely a newfound respect for what those folks do every day.
Absolutely. Absolutely. So, you know, if we can all walk away with a little more perspective and a little bit greater empathy, then I think, you know, maybe we come out obviously stronger, but we might also come out better people as well. So,
I agree. Fully agree.
George, this has been awesome. Thank you so much for talking and having coffee with me this morning. I know this is probably, well, you're an hour ahead, so this was probably like your third cup. I think you have two more to go.
Three or four.
Thank you so much. And you guys have a wonderful Thanksgiving. You as well, George. Thanks. And I will see you on the flip.
You got it. Thank you very much.
Thanks. Bye, guys.